Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm Scarlett from Miss Money, and if you know me, you know I'm all about AMC, and we're just moments away from this stock truly exploding. At least, it feels that way right now. But I'll start with the bearish news before we get into more exciting AMC announcements. And before we do dive into some of this big time AMC news, do me a quick favor and like this video and subscribe to the channel. Join our money fam here of winners and comment down below any stocks you'd like me to cover in future episodes. Now let's dive in. AMC stock has truly skyrocketed, and four executives recently sold a total of $3 million of shares. In just 2021, we've seen some crazy action from AMC. The stock has rocketed so far in 2021 with volatile trading, and executives of the theater chain recently sold large amounts of stock after selling none last year. In fact, for three out of four of the executives, these are their first stock sales on the open market on record. AMC increased nearly 400% year to date. A lot of this had to do with social media, Reddit chains, you know, Wall Street bets. At one point when shares hit $20.36 in January, they were trading at nearly 10 times the year-end price of $2.12. The S&P 500 index has managed to rise only 5.8% so far this year. Okay, so let's do some juicy news. So the four executives sold a total of nearly $3 million of AMC stock earlier this month. AMC didn't immediately respond to a request to make them available for comment on their stock sales. Getting a bit deeper into this, the selling was led by Stephen Colanero, Executive Vice President and Chief Marketing Officer, who sold 100,000 AMC shares on March 23rd for $1.1 million, or $10.52 each on average. He now owns 108,879 shares, according to a form he filled with the SEC. Colanero, who has been with the company since 2009, last sold stock in June 2018, receiving $86,000 for 5,364 shares, a per share average of $15.95. Kevin Connor, Senior VP, General Counsel, and Secretary, sold a total of 72,352 AMC shares over March 16th and 17th for $982,600, a per share average of $13.58. Connor, who has been with the company since 2007, now owns 65,884 AMC shares. And Elizabeth Frank, Executive VP, Worldwide Programming, and Chief Content Officer, sold 40,000 AMC shares on March 16th for $542,400, an average price of $13.56 each. Frank, who has been with the company since 2012, now owns 173,780 shares. And lastly, Chris Cox, the Senior VP and Chief Accounting Officer, sold 29,068 AMC shares on March 16th for $373,800, a per share average of $12.86. He now owns 42,000 shares. AMC executives aren't the only recent stock sellers. Private equity firm Silver Lake, which has been one of the company's largest investors, sold its entire stake in January for $713 million. So, AMC continues to be hit with the social media crowd rallying around this stock. AMC stock was up more than 27% despite showing no real signs of improvement in its business. It continues to issue new shares with less than ideal immediate growth prospects, which are likely to overwhelm even the short sellers, sadly. And AMC runs, you know, one of the world's largest theater chains. It has 950 theaters spread across the US, and it has 14 foreign locations. Of course, as I've talked about before, AMC was harshly hit by the pandemic. I mean, all the theater chains were, but I am still optimistic that once things get back to normal, people will return to the movie theater experience because it is an experience after all, overpriced popcorn and soda included. And let's think about it. So in the past couple of months, AMC stock was up more than 100%. However, with its debt levels, it's forced to issue more stock, resulting in more dilution and limiting another squeeze's prospects. So in the short term, I'll be honest, because I want to be honest with you guys, with the bearish news, this doesn't look great for the short term. And yes, it is fairly bearish news, but hold out because we'll recover. It's only a matter of time before AMC really does explode, as the title indicates. AMC has roughly $5.7 billion in long-term debt as per its latest quarter. These numbers are before accounting for its massive operating lease liabilities worth $5 billion. Additionally, the company's posted a whopping $4.5 billion loss last year. Perhaps the company's saving grace is that it has close to $1 billion cash in hand, which is something that I think makes it seem a bit strong here for recovery. Its massive debt load restricts its ability to attain capital for future projects. Also, the high interest in its debt suggests that more dilution is sadly on the way. So a bit more bearish news, especially in the shorter term here. Paying more than $400 million in finance costs is a huge burden. Therefore, limiting its debt is a prime concern at this time. AMC's weighted average shares were 152.3 million in the fourth quarter last year. However, these shares have shot up to 450 million at this time. The company's market capitalization is crazy right now, considering the lack of growth prospects and its substantial debt load. To put things in perspective, its market capitalization is around 5 times higher than what it was just before the pandemic. So let's get on to some more bullish news. You know, we had to cover, be realistic about everything that's going on. And the 2021 outlook for movie theaters is likely to improve significantly as the world gets a pandemic grip. COVID-19 hospitalizations in the US are slowing down, and it is expected that new COVID infections will drop by mid-year. And with COVID vaccine rollout, I mean, things are looking up, especially for people getting back to normalcy, whatever that is. So attendance numbers at theaters are still considerably low. AMC's January attendance was down 92% and 90% in February. I expect AMC's revenue to rebound significantly as the big budget films release from the second quarter and beyond. AMC is a survivor, and not just because it's been around for over 100 years. AMC has stayed open to keep its brand alive and relevant and here. Regal, of course, shut down sadly during the pandemic, but AMC is still here. AMC will be able to gobble up market share even if it will be a shrinking pie. Analysts see at least 3 more years of red ink, and AMC has been raising money to be sure it makes it through this rough patch. As I've talked about, raising this cash capital is really what's gonna keep it going. AMC has made the most of the pandemic lull to beef up mobile ordering for concessions, offer assigned seating for screenings, and even create the option to rent out an entire theater on the cheap, which I think is super cool for like a birthday party, just a little outing, whatever you want to do. If it can adapt to the future as well as it's trying in the present, do you really want to bet against an industry leader? I think that this is amazing. And what if the future of AMC is showing new releases on some of its larger screens, but also catering to a fantasy football league on draft night, a rising improv troupe performing live in another, and a charity bingo game at the same time? Who knows? The country's largest multiplex operator has raised enough money to give it more than time than most competitors. So recently, looking at the numbers, we've seen AMC consolidate at just above $10, which is still much higher than what was originally anticipated. I mean, just a year ago, it was barely above $3 per share, and that was at the time when the pandemic was really hitting businesses hard. In mid-March of this year, AMC hit almost $14 per share, and I think this pullback that we've seen recently has to do with the dilution of the stock. And if you hang on there a bit longer and we see AMC stay at the $10 mark for even longer, it'll only be a matter of time before AMC hits back up toward $14 again, and I definitely see $20 very soon. But fundamentally, you really have to be willing to hold AMC for more than a year before it truly recovers as a business. But once it does, I do believe people will be flooding to AMC for that movie experience. And hopefully in the shorter term, maybe with the summer with vaccine rollout, we'll really start to foreshadow that full recovery. Well, guys, that's all I have for today. I'm Scarlett, and thanks for watching.